大家好，歡迎大家繼續收睇《張一長談》呢個節目，我哋節目主持人姚永安。咁啊，好高興咧，我哋係能夠請嚟咧呢位係聯邦新民主黨嘅黨領早面成 Jamit Singh，今日就同我哋傾下偈。咁啊喺上一節咧，佢就講咗新民主黨嘅一啲主張，同埋一啲政策，同埋希望政府能夠提供嘅服務嘅。咁啊好啦，咁啊究竟呢啲服務錢喺邊度嚟咧？咁我而家問佢啦。Jamit, welcome to our show.
Thank
In the
you.
last session, you mentioned about some of the big program like housing or pharma care. But people would also think where the money come from.
So where the money comes from, a couple of places. One is we've got to look at some of the things that we want to do as investments. So the same way we make an investment, it costs us money upfront, but at the end of the day, we actually get a return on that investment. So I think we should look at pharma care as one of those things. It's an investment, because when we invest in pharma care, we actually would save, according to the Parliamentary Budget Officer, about $4 billion federally. So it's an investment, but it would create a savings that we could reinvest in helping build up a better healthcare
So,
system.
for example, because of the PharmaCare program, people doesn't need to go to the hospital, then it could save up taxpayers' money.
Absolutely,
Okay.
many different ways. So it would save, if you factor in those savings for provinces, some people put the figure as high as $9 billion of savings. So federally, there's programs delivered where for seniors, for indigenous community folks, for different people, we provide prescription medication covered. This would actually result in a massive savings for us federally. But in terms of how we can afford some of the programs we want, there's a lot of tax loopholes that exist right now. And those tax loopholes mean billions of dollars that we don't actually get in revenue because of these loopholes that people are using. We would close some of those loopholes. So we're talking about CEO stock options, which could raise up to $1 billion, capital gains exemptions, which are loopholes that people use, as well as offshore tax havens. So there's a number of different loopholes that exist right now that, if we close them, would actually increase our revenue by billions of dollars, and we could use that to invest in programs that would help lift people up.
咁你頭先講咗一啲唔同嘅方法啦。咁其實你講緊話，即係呢個一啲即係税收咧，即係話所謂税收嘅漏洞啦，尤其是對啲大有錢嘅人啊、啲大企業嘅時候咧，其實我都覺得呢個係咪即係新民主黨同埋兩個所謂天然執政黨自由黨、保守黨嘅分別？因為你其實如果睇到佢哋執政嘅時候咧，硬係呢啲大企業啊、呢啲最有錢嘅人咧，就係落得最高嘅利益嘅。譬如話好似呢個加拿大嘅聯邦嘅利得税咁樣，咁啊從前37%，咁啊由自由黨同保守黨輪流執政咧，咁啊減到而家15%，即係對於我嚟講咧，就話政府係失去咗好多好多嘅税收嘅。咁當然有人講就係話，哦，如果你唔減税俾佢哋會走噶啦。咁但係問題事實上就係呢啲錢喺加拿大賺嘅。咁同埋仲有就係話，即係好似你話，如果係黃金銀行啊、Rogers 啊、Bell Canada 咁樣啊，如果佢係走咗嘅話，根本就賺唔到啲錢。喺呢度加拿大賺嘅錢應該入加拿大嘅税，咁但係從前嘅同埋而家嘅政府咧就減咗好多税俾佢哋嘅。咁我想問下你，即係新民主黨嘅睇法點啦？
Well, exactly what you said. I mean, we believe that those who have the means to contribute to society should be paying their fair share. And for a long time, the people who actually have the ability to contribute have been told you can pay less and less, you can contribute less and less, you can help build up our society less and less. That doesn't make sense to me. If you've got people who can contribute, who've got the means to do so, they should be paying their fair share. They should be contributing and adding in to build up the society. So we believe that Canada provides a lot of competitive advantage with our highly educated workforce, with our stable government, with our healthcare system. It's a big draw. And if we add in things like PharmaCare, it'll be an increased draw. It'll reduce the cost for companies when they have to provide benefits for their employees. So there's a lot of advantages to being in Canada. And I believe absolutely that the corporations and wealthy businesses should have to contribute their fair share. That's the only way we can move forward in building a fair society.
好啦，咁啊要講下本地嘅政治啦。咁啊好高興咧，我哋就知道咧，你已經係出嚟講咗，就係你會喺本拿比嘅南區咧，就係去競選做呢個補選，就做國會議員嘅。咁就其實咧，點解你會嚟 BC 省去競選嘅咧？咁頭先你都講你喺安省長大噶嘛。咁同埋就係話你係唔係第一個聯邦嘅政黨嘅領袖係喺 BC 省度係競選咧？
Well, good questions. First question is, I wasn't only raised in Ontario. I also lived in Newfoundland, Labrador. So I've kind of lived across the country, East Coast, lived in Ontario. And moving to West Coast only makes sense. I've got a wide experience of Canada. The other real thing is, if you look at work we've done so far, we've tried really hard as New Democrats to put pressure on this government to do what people need. Mm. On housing, this government has let people down with a plan that won't actually do anything until after the next federal election. On the environment, the Liberal government has let down people by buying a pipeline when no one wanted us to buy a pipeline. No one in Canada thought it makes sense for the federal government to purchase something that the private sector is saying it's not going to raise a profit. It's not going to be profitable. That doesn't make sense for our Liberal government or our government to be doing that. It makes no sense at all. So the government has let us down, and there's a by-election coming up. So I think it's important to continue to put that pressure on the government to do what's right, to do what people need, to do right by people, to make sure, you know, we're not told to wait for change. Mm-hmm. They said, okay, just wait on PharmaCare, just wait on the housing plan. They're telling, you know, the people of Burnaby to just wait. They're telling the people of Canada to just wait. I'm saying, and what people are saying is, we can't wait anymore. We need immediate action. So this gives us a chance to use the platform as a national leader to raise the concerns of Burnaby, which are also major concerns for all of Canada, and to put that pressure on the federal government to do what's necessary. So that's why we're doing it.
Okay. 嗱，我知道咧，就你已經喺 Burnaby 就敲緊門噶啦。咁其實你同啲選民傾偈嘅時候咧，首先啲選民認唔認識你啦，同埋仲有就係話佢同你講啲乜嘢咧？
So I'm getting lots of great responses at the doors. A lot of folks are saying that they've seen me on TV and they've seen the work we've done. They've seen the work I've done, and so it's really encouraging. It's really humbling. You also asked the question. I forgot to answer that. People brought this up as well, that there hasn't been a federal leader from British Columbia in a long time. And this would be, you know, the first time in a while that a federal leader would be representing a riding in BC. One of the times in the past, in the New Democrat history, the first leader of the NDP, Tommy Douglas, represented from actually Burnaby when he was first a leader federally. So there's a bit of history there, and some folks pointed that out. They said, oh, this is a riding where Tommy first ran, and it makes sense that now you as leader are also running here. So that was something interesting I heard at the doors. But there's a lot of issues, I would say top issues. Housing comes up every day. Healthcare comes up, whether it's building a new hospital in Burnaby or whether it's healthcare in general. The fact that there's not enough funds or resources for healthcare and people are worried about getting the type of care that they want to see for their family and their loved ones. I think that's a real concern. And people are really interested in the idea of PharmaCare for all. And then I would say the final issue that comes up, top issue, is in the environment. How we can protect our water, the land, the air. People are really worried about forest fires. What we saw in the last two summers in a row here in BC, some of the worst forest fires ever. So people are really feeling concerned about the environment. And now with the new report that came out from the United Nations saying if we don't take serious action in the next 12 years, we could be in a catastrophic position for the planet. So the environment is also a big issue, and we're really concerned about how we can do our part as a country and as a people to reduce emissions and to transition towards a green economy.
Mm-hmm. 你頭先啱講嘅就係話，即係喺你之前，其實好耐以前咧，新民主黨嘅創黨黨領咧 ，Tommy Douglas 亦都喺呢個本拿比係選過嘅，咁其實即係佢係偶像嚟嘅，因為其實佢亦都係被選為係最偉大嘅加拿大人，因為我哋加拿大嘅全民保健咧就係佢當年係創辦嘅，雖然佢未執過政。咁啊，另外我想問下你啦，就係即係你都講咗少少啦，就係環境嘅問題。咁啊喺本拿比嚟講咧，就好明顯，因為從前亦都喺嗰度發生漏油嘅事故啦。咁就呢個 Kinder Morgan 嘅輸油管咧，就係一個大嘅議題嚟嘅。尤其是聯邦政府係用45亿元嘅納税人嘅錢去買咗呢條從前即係只係5亿元買翻嚟嘅油管9倍嘅價錢，同埋經常漏油嘅。咁你點樣睇政府咁樣使納税人嘅錢咧？咁同埋就係話可唔可以清楚講點解你係反對呢個Kinder Morgan 嘅咧
？Absolutely, I can tell you some of the reasons. Well, one of the reasons is, anytime there's a business project or a business plan, if the company itself, if the private sector itself doesn't see any profit in that business or in that plan, why would the federal government then step in? So Kinder Morgan tried to sell the project, no one would buy it. they realized that they couldn't move ahead with it, so they said, okay, let's stop moving ahead with it. Then the federal government purchased the existing pipeline for $4.5 billion. From what we understand, the actual value of the pipeline is far less than that. The actual value of it is far less, maybe barely $1 billion. So the company has seen a massive profit from selling it. And they also put a clause in the agreement, which is very interesting. They said, even if the federal approval is not approved, if there's not federal approvals or permits, the sale still has to go ahead. So normally when you purchase something, if I was going to buy a house, I would put an agreement, okay, subject to inspection. But imagine I bought a house, and even though I put subject to inspection, the owner said, even if the inspection has failed, you still have to buy the house. That's pretty much what we did. It makes no sense. And now to build the expansion, the government's looking at the expansion. Initially, they said it would be $7 billion. Now new reports are saying it would be actually as much as $10 billion. And even more reports are saying that it could be as much as $15 billion. So this is going to cost us almost $20 billion. It makes no sense to spend $20 billion on one pipeline. That is a horrible use of our dollars, a horrible use of our public money, our taxpayer dollars. This is not the right thing to do. It's not a good economic case, and it's not good for the environment. So for many reasons, we're opposed to this project.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Also, 總理就一直講啦，就話呢個係加拿大人嘅利益。 咁就因為話，如果我哋唔見條絲毫管咧，咁就啲油咧就唔會賣到去亞洲噶啦。咁但係問題就係話，如果我哋睇翻即係一啲政府嘅 statistic 嘅數字咧，去年即係呢個亞省透過 BC 省出口嘅油咧，其實 99% 係去曬即係美國嘅煉油廠嘅。咁其實
Well, it's a really good question that you write and that you put forward, and the same question we've been asking. If the majority of the oil right now that's being pumped into through this pipeline, if the majority of it is sold to the states, why would pumping more oil automatically open up a new market? If the market was there, why aren't we selling to that market now? And so it really makes this question is a very appropriate question. If you're selling 5 units of whatever, and the most of those units are going to the one buyer, if you make, instead of 5 units, you make it 15 units, why would that somehow mean that a new market would be opened up? There's no evidence. So I think there's a lot of myths in what's being proposed. We don't know for certain that this is going to open up any new markets. Right now, majority is being sold to the states, and it looks like any increase would also continue to go to refineries in the states. The type of oil that's produced is a very difficult oil to refine. It's not like other oils which are in a better state, which are easier to then quickly transition to what we need them to be. Diluted bitumen oil is very difficult to refine. Only limited places can refine it. So it's not like many markets have the opportunity or the facilities to refine it. So there's a lot of questions about what this project will actually do for Canada. In terms of the jobs created, most of the jobs that have been cited would be short-term, just during the construction phase, not long-term jobs, not jobs that are continuing. And then if you look at the risk side of things in BC, there's over 130,000 jobs that are in the tourism and fisheries sectors. If there's any oil spill, and there's an increased rate of oil spill, or increased chance of oil spill with so many more tankers coming through the Burrard Inlet, any oil spill could threaten those 130,000 jobs. If the oil spills, we don't know how to clean it up. We don't know how to protect the coastline, and it could have serious impacts. So for so many reasons, this is not good for Canada, it's not good for BC, and it is not in the best interest of our country.
OK，最後一條問題我想問你啦，咁亦都必須問嘅，咁就係13歲嘅華裔少女咧，申少宇咧，就喺中央公園咧，就喺呢個選區裏邊嘅。 咁就呢件事亦都引起好多華人嘅好大嘅反應，咁甚至亦都係出嚟示威，咁就將呢樣嘢咧就話係政府嘅難民政策所造成嘅。咁我想問下你嘅睇法係點樣啦？What
happened to that young girl is just horrible. It is a terrible tragedy, and no family should have to go through that. No young girl should go through that. That is just inexplicable and I don't have the words to describe how terrible that is. We can't, and we've got to make sure we don't let this ever happen again. We've got to make sure our society is safe, and so that, you know, no one has to experience that. That's never happens again. We also need to make sure that we don't allow this horrible incident to be exploited by people who want to divide us, who want to use these horrible incidents as justification to divide communities against each other. We know immigrant communities, new Canadians, are the vast majority peace-loving, are law-abiding, and contribute to our society and do a great job to contribute to our society. So we can't let people try to exploit this incident to divide us. We need to stick together, build a better world together, and make sure that it's safe for everyone, and don't let hate or division divide us in any way.
Okay, hold on. Thanks for taking this interview.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. 好啦，今日時間到呢度啦。咁就下個禮拜咧，我有另一個話題同大家繼續討論嘅。拜拜。